I'm cooking! Exciting! Alright, hopefully the chat thing's working, but eh, who cares? Alright, I'll just use this. Chat control. Alright, cool! Hi, everybody! First ever Cooking with Chilii. Pretty exciting. So, what I'm going to be doing today is making chicken Alfredo. But instead of using spaghetti, wait over here. Spaghetti squash. Because I'm on a diet! Alright, so first thing, take this off. Just so you guys know, I've actually never made this before, so I've never made it before, so hopefully this comes out well. Alright, so first thing I gotta do. Let that dry for a second. Here's my pancakes. I have to preheat my oven. Right? Whenever I come over here, it's because I'm checking my phone to make sure I have the thing right. And also so I can make dramatic exits! Alright, I believe it's 300. Bake. Alright, start! Alright, so. God damn it, Alexa. Yes, I have an Alexa. She's a little bitch. I'm not talking to you right now.
I'm not sure what you meant by that question.
It wasn't a question. All right, so. Ooh, very thirsty. So, bring the trash can over. So the first thing I gotta do is cut the spaghetti squash, which, actually, let me get another. Get one more cutting board thing. So, the funny thing is, I actually used to work at, oh, hi, John! So, I apologize for the janky quality of this webcam, and also the thing in general, because this is on my laptop. So, this took me literally half an hour to get this shit set up right. So, what I'm gonna do for you guys right now, jump to here. So, I need to cut the spaghetti squash first. Turn this down a little bit and get to that. Maybe? Or is it gonna fall? Probably gonna fall? Alright, fine. I'll switch positions on. So, I gotta cut the spaghetti squash first, which I used to work at a shop right, which is a royal pain in the ass because usually these things are really like, not tough, but like, well, you'll see. Let's see if I'm as strong as I think I am. Also, wait, this is a salad cutter, dum-dum. Right next to me. This is what I mean. I'm so stupid. I'm gonna grab you the knife. Watch my streams and follow me. Wait, that's my chicken knife. I'm a goddamn mess already. Alright, so. Like I said, this is always a pain in the ass to cut through. Alright, this is already not even, but who cares? We'll deal with that later. Alright, so we have cut it open. Okay, so now that's cut open, we've got to get a spoon and scoop out the inside. Kind of like pumpkin-y, almost. I've actually never eaten spaghetti squash. I used to, like I said, I've cut it open before. I'm not looking at it, I can't see my face. I've worked in the produce section at a shop right like a couple summers ago, and there's people like, these are kind of hard to cut. It was not cut hard for me because my knife's used to sharpen, but there's people who come to shop right specifically to ask me, the produce guy, like, oh, can you, I want to buy spaghetti squash, can you cut it for me? It's like, what the fuck do you mean if I cut it for you? Like, do you have a knife at home? But apparently, like, they think, like, it's really too fucking hard, so whatever. Alright, so let's scoop out all this gross shit. Oh, also, John, let me know how the volume is in general. So maybe I have to talk louder, or if I have to turn off the music, or turn it up, or whatever. Guys, yes. So it kind of reminds me of the inside of a pumpkin, honestly. But I guess that makes sense because they're both fucking gourds and squashes. Oh my god, would you just fucking get out of there, please? Thank you. Alright, so. There we go. There's one half. Power to be strong, and the wisdom to be wise. Right, let's get the other half now. Volume is good, music not loud enough to be heard, but I feel like nice. Yeah, I like it's loud for me, but I want to make it loud enough that like you guys can hear it, but not like so loud that it's like obnoxious. Right now it's my little stupid bitch Alexa, who is across the room. Well, not across the room. Whatever. Come on. Get out of there! Old bastard. Good. Alright. Thank God you guys can't see my floats. I'm getting the shit everywhere. There's no one there to guide you. Take your hand, and understand me. Alright, let's get a little bit more. So basically, what I've seen so far is that when this eventually does cook, it gets really like it literally looks like spaghetti, which is kind of cool, which I guess is why they fucking call it spaghetti squash. That would make sense, obviously. Let's turn that off real quick. Boop. Having Chicken Alfredo tonight. Well, the funny thing is, ever since Katie and I started our diets, we've been eating, like, just a shit ton of chicken, like, all the time. All right. Hold on. Where's my broom? Over here. I get my dustpan and my broom to clean up this shit. Because Katie will be mad at me if there's stuff on the floor. It was actually funny, too, because I was, I told her when I was at work, I was like, listen, when I get home, I'll cook the spaghetti squash and the chicken. And she was like, all right, well, like, wait till I get home. I hope. I was like, listen, well, but I had this idea to actually stream it. So I was like, hey, that would be fun. Because I know people usually do that. Just something to add to my repertoire, basically. So I told her, I was like, well, I'm streaming. She's like, well, I want to learn how to make it. And she was also like, well, how does the house look? I'm like, well, what do you mean? I was like, it's clean. She's like, is it your clean or is it my clean? I was like, why not? Move. All right, so this is almost ready, which is good. So I need to get aluminum foil, which I have right here. All right, and I need to put foil on the pan. Okay. Oh shit! The other thing, I need the camera. No, I forgot that my shelves are right here. Sorry. Oh, that's funny! Alright, so I have vegetable oil. Where the hell is my olive oil? Did I use it all? God damn it. Alright, we're using vegetable oil! Fuck it, we'll do it live. Alright, do that. Alright, so we are good and preheated. Now, the one thing wait! Hold on. I gotta grab something! So, the one thing I actually forgot I needed was I need a brush to, like, brush in... Well, let me double check. Because what happens is when you actually have the both halves of the squash ready, you have to actually, put olive oil. And I didn't need my ears. Sorry! and you need to, like, basically... You have to, like, brush in, like, olive oil and pepper and stuff to make it go evenly. I forgot we don't have one of those brushes, but I do have one for, like, a grill. So I can just use that instead. Alright. 350, it's just 300, right? 350, god damn it! Alright, no matter. So, I don't have olive oil, I'm gonna use vegetable oil instead. I don't think there's that big of a difference. I'm gonna go to the internet, check. Because for some reason, like, I cook my chicken in vegetable oil all the time. And I think it's the same. Or not the same, but, like, not too bad. Vegetable oil versus olive oil. Not in bacon, just in general. What was that? The, like, yellow, or was it the what's it called? Hey, all right, cool. Vegetable oil is fine. So, what I'm going to do is it raining or is it snowing again? I can't. It's, I don't care. It. So, John, you might know this. All those. Yeah, olive oil is thicker, so let's use this instead. So let's do this a couple little dabs here. It's a lot, but whatever. So today was pretty ridiculous. When I woke up this morning, Katie was like, "Hey, too bad it didn't snow last night." And I was like, "What are you talking about? Like, I didn't even know it was supposed to." And she's like, "Yeah, someone said it was supposed to snow last night, but of course it ended up not snowing." So I'm like, "Whatever. I mean, it's March and it was just like 60 degrees like 2 days ago." So finally, I go to work, and it's kind of wet. It's a little rainy this morning, and then all of a sudden, about like probably I don't even know what time. Like I was in second period, so about like probably 9 o'clock. 9 o'clock, 9:15. I look out the window, and it's like flurries, and I'm like, all right, well, that's weird. I guess here comes the snow. Throughout the day, it got like progressively worse. Like there was like a little mini, we had like a mini blizzard, and all the kids were like, oh my god, we have to go home, like it's not safe for us to be here. And I was like, all right, shut up, like you're fine, like you're not, it's not that big of a deal. So eventually, like end of the day comes around, I look outside, not only did it stop snowing, it's like sunny out. It was still 37, but it was like hot. So I was like, what the fuck, like what is with March? It's so odd. Hopefully that works. So maybe if I do that. Okay, the next step, if I remember correctly, was the salt and pepper. Where is my salt and pepper? See, this is a realistic cooking show. Someone's like, now we're going to do this. And I'm like, where the fuck is everything? Behind the goddamn paper towels, of course. All right, so, let me just double check to make sure. Do I spread this shit around too, or do I just spread out? See, I'm a man of the people, guys. This is a realistic cooking show right now. All right, spread that around, I did that part, sprinkle it, all right, just sprinkle it, all right. Pepper, salt. Okay, is that ready? That's ready. So, flip these upside down. These go in here for half an hour. Start. Okay. Not 30 seconds. No. I thought it was 30 seconds. Good God. All right. Yeah, welcome to the Northeast, pretty much. All right. So, I am done with this now. I'm going to bring this back over. Okay. So, now I get to cook the chicken. So, in their recipe that I saw, they took one chicken breast and just cut it in half. And then just cook both sides. I don't like doing that, actually, because I feel like it takes too long. And the centers of it never get cooked right. So I pre-chop it and use it that way. Okay, so let's bring out my chicken. Wash my hands first. Wash your hands. So, look at my head. Ah! Always make sure you wash your hands when you're cooking, just to be safe. Although I feel like in a second I'm going to grab something out of this cabinet and forget the fucking camera's there and just knock you guys off again. Ah, it's hot. It is snowing again. Son of a bitch. Also, John, I hope you like my my sign over here. That was a gift from one of my friends a couple months ago. I got to say, that's probably the biggest casualty in my, my war, my diet, pretty much. Can't drink Rolling Rocks anymore. I can, actually. I looked it up. They're actually not that bad for you. Maybe I just can't drink as much. All right, so hands are washed. Knife is out. Knife is also washed. I hand washed it before the stream. Now we cut in and we grab our chicken. Come on. Get out of there. It's still a little frozen because it was defrosting all day today. There we go. Alright, so move that to there. So now this is my chicken hand. This is my chicken hand. I always, it's funny because I hate having to keep washing my hands, so whatever, I usually use my left hand to touch the chicken, and right hand is like moving things around, cutting with the knife and things like that. So, speaking of which, let me chicken hand. Throw my vegetable oil in the bottom of the chicken pan. Just a little bit. There we go. Okay. I wanna be where the people are. Let's cut this little shell off. Should I bring you? You know, yeah, I will. I'm gonna bring you guys down a little bit closer. Give me a second. Out of the cabinet. This is what I said I was going to do. I'm going to do this right. Hold on. Hold on! I figured this out. Camera's going nuts. Okay, so pull shit down. You know what I should do first? Hold on. Why don't I do this real quick? So you're not fucking being thrown around all the time. And now figure it out. So if I could do this first. Or I could just. That's exactly what I'm doing. I'm going to use Katie's little stupid coffee mate thing. Damn it! This is so. This is so annoying! There we go. Alright, so. That's actually good. I'll leave it like that. Perfect. Let's move this out of the way then. So now you guys have a better view of the chicken. Like that. Alright, so I always cut this shit off. I'm not really a big fan of the. Not just like it's like that's fat. It's just like. I don't like it. I should say if there's ever too much of it, that's when I cut it off. Okay, anything else needed? Not really. Okay. Oh, my finger! I'm kidding. Actually, I shouldn't even joke because that's like actually one of my biggest fears. Alright, I don't start the actual burner until I've already cut at least like one and a half. Actually, I don't really start until it's completely done. Guys here a little bit. Ooh. Nope, the other way. I want to move you the other way. Bam! Alright, so I always cut it. I cut them in these strips, and then I cut the strips basically in half. And I kind of go from there, because there's a couple times, like, honestly, depending on what I want to eat with, or what I want the chicken to be, like, whatever the meal is, it'll actually depend on how thick I cut it, just because, like, for instance, when I make salads, I cut the chicken to be a little bit thicker, just because, like, there's really not as many pieces. I get strong winds right now. Not really. At least I haven't been outside since I got home an hour or two ago. So we very well could be getting like fucking hurricane winds out there. I had no idea. So like with salads, I make them a little bit bigger just because I think like with salads have like just a few bigger pieces where like when I make pasta or if I make, sometimes I make like chicken and broccoli, I use them a little bit, make them a little bit smaller. We definitely are. Over you, stronger yet. Let's be high. Oh, I've cut that off. keep on cutting, keep on cutting. This is actually probably the most monotonous part of it, just having to cut everything up. And it's funny because one of the few reasons that I wouldn't cook, like sometimes like Katie cooks, sometimes I cook. I mostly cook. She's not very good. I just hate having to cut everything up. It's such a pain in the ass. And I know what you're probably gonna say, like, oh, just cut it in half one time and put that in. Yeah, I do, hypothetical viewer, but at the same time, the problem I always run into, and I don't know why, I just can't figure it out, if I cut it in half and I cook both sides, like, both sides start to burn. And, like, I have it on medium heat. It's not that hot. But some of them, like, they're on, like, cooking through both sides, but the middle is always still raw, and it's just really frustrating. And I don't know if it's because I'm just doing a shitty job, or if I'm just, like, or if my chicken is too thick, or if it's the stove, I don't know. So I'd rather just make it simple, cut it into chunks now. Because a lot of times what I do is, when I cut, or when I cook, I should say, I end up just cutting it into chunks anyway, because that's how I figure out if it's cooked or not. You guys getting some good footage here, cutting these chickens, cutting the little chicky chicks. Let's cut this one in half too. All right, knife down, knife hand touching the bottom. Let's scrape the rest of these into the pan, move them around a bit. All right. So now I'm going to do the second piece of chicken. Let's do this one. This one looks kind of big. Of course, it's fucking. She's on vacation far away. Alrighty. First things first, cut that shit off. Cut that shit off. Like, it's funny, because I know it's just fat, and, like, it's not that big of a deal, and honestly, when it comes to fat, like, when I eat steaks, I actually love fat on steaks. I think it's delicious. But, like, something about just, like, fat on chicken, I'm like, no, thank you. Alright, I feel like this is not sharp. Here, I gotta do something real quick. So, non-knife hand touching the faucet. Or should I wash my knife hand for a second? So I want to wash this just for a quick second because I want to sharpen it. And I feel like I don't want to sharpen it. It's got raw chicken on it and, like, salmonella. All right, there we go. Knife is clean. Drying the knife. Oh, speaking of which, I realize I should probably switch the fucking cameras if I'm actually going out. Make that a little better for you. Alright, so I have my knife sharpener. Sharpen it real quick. Ah, looks pretty cool, right? Sharpen it up just to make it a little bit easier. Alright, should be good enough. Put the sharpener back. Alright, to the chicken! There we go. That's much better. Now it's cutting right through. Alright, and sometimes the one aggravating thing that happens is a lot of times what I'll do is, alright, watch. So, can you see? Yeah. So I'll cut here like this, and I'll be left with this, like a piece of chicken that looks like this, and what I'll do is I'll do one, two, usually three cuts. Turn it, keep it together, and then just cut down the middle to make, like, eight pieces. And a lot of times if I pick it up like this and put it in, they're all still stuck together. So actually what happened is, like, when it cooks, they end up, like, I cut them into, like, eight separate pieces, but they end up cooking together and making, like, three, like, mishmashes. See, John, now it's sunny. Like, it was just snowing. Like, flurries, like, a lot of snow. And now it's... Fucking New Jersey. New Jersey weather in March is just like March is drunk. I need some better music. Alexa, play Danger Zone by Kenny Loggins.
Danger Zone by Kenny Loggins from Spotify.
This is my fucking go-to cooking song. I know, John. Alexa, volume 10. Bam. Love me some Danger Zone. Revving up your engine, listen to a howling roar. Highway to the Danger Zone. And also, the one funny thing about cutting this has been sitting out defrosting all day. Like, I order Alexa around, a little bitch. So this has been sitting out all day. So it's funny because, like, the bottom of it is still pretty, like this part here is still pretty icy, but, like, this part's squishy. So it's funny cutting it. Danger Zone! Right into the Danger Zone! It's also funny too because I wonder if my upstairs neighbor thinks like do I listen to, because I pretty much anytime I cook, which recently has been like almost every night, I always fucking listen to Danger Zone. So I'm kind of curious if my neighbor is like, does he ever not listen to fucking Danger Zone? Who knows? All right, Alexa, you're older. Alexa, volume 8. Calm your tits. Alexa. Getting a little too rowdy back there, Alexa. I wasn't talking to you this time! God! This is not like a joke for stream. Like, I argue with Alexa all the fucking time. Because especially when I'll be talking about something completely random, and like all of a sudden like she pops up like, I don't understand that. I was like, bitch, I was not talking to you.
To the Danger Zone. Take a ride into the Danger Zone. Highway to the Danger Zone.
Alright, so chicken is all good and accounted for. Just wash this off real quick. Wash off the chicky chicks thing. Wash my hands. Because cleanliness is important. Soap. Okay, so we've got 15 minutes left on the squash, so now we get to cook the awesome chicken. Now here's the thing, I want to move this so you can see. Alright, I'm going to move you guys back up to the top of the...
Move you guys back up here.
Right. Oh, perfect. Okay, that looks good. So, I will warn you, my fire alarm, or my fire detector, or smoke detector, I should say, is really a bitch. So, I have to make sure I have this fan on. So, I'm going to put it on low. I hope it's not so... Well, I feel like I can still talk a little bit, obviously. But, just in head. Alexa! Shut up! God. So... I'm going to turn the music off just because, like, I don't think you guys can probably even still hear it with the fan on. So, light this bad boy up. Oh, it's on. Okay. Put it about medium. Get my tongs out. Oh, God. Almost dropped them. Didn't drop them. So good. So let's just move these around a bit. Make sure everything's here on the bottom. So, usually, what I've done previously... At least, I usually just cook the chicken itself, and that's it. Just leave it plain. But one of my students, actually, she's also on a diet, and actually, it's funny, because she's trying to join the military, so she has to lose weight, and her friend, who's also in the military, has to gain weight. And she's like 4'11", like 100 pounds. And I'm like, bitch, you need to eat all the time. I don't say bitch to her, really. She's a nice girl. But basically... she knows a lot about, like, nutrition, because, like, she's had to design her own fucking diet. So I was like, all right, listen, would you mind helping me out? Like, I would really appreciate it if you could give me some tips. So she did. She gave me a whole, actually, probably over here. Hold on. I'm grabbing it right now. Oh, I ripped it. Damn it. So I ripped it, but here it is. So, like, she gave me this, which, so my meal plan of breakfast, lunch, and dinner, and then also a workout thing on the back, which is kind of cool. Man, I'm doing the workout thing. I've gone to the gym, like, for fucking 30 years now. Oh, God, I'm almost 30. That's so fucking weird. Sorry, John. No offense. So I told her, like, listen, what can I make? And she, where am I going with this story? What was I trying to say? God damn it. Oh, I make a lot of chicken. So, she recommended that she always puts, like, seasonings on her chicken while she's making it. So, Katie went out for groceries. Sorry, John. So, Katie went out for groceries, and she got this. It's garlic, and it's Mrs. Dash garlic and herb seasoning. And I like it. I really do. Just kind of sprinkle it in while it's cooking. And then it just adds whatever flavor it is. So usually what I'll do is if I know I'm adding the seasoning, I'll keep cooking it like this. So as you guys can tell, hopefully, I don't know if it's showing it well enough, it's still pink right now. So what I'll do is I'll kind of move it around a bit. Once the bottom layer of it is white, I'll flip it and then I'll add in the seasoning and let that cook in with the second side. Actually, you know what? Hold on. Let me see if I can finally move you guys down to here. Let me see if this will work. I'll put you guys. Oh, perfect. That's even better. Okay. So, so like you said, like right here, you can still see that there's a little bit of white here, but it's still mostly, if not all, pink. So I'm just kind of moving it around just to make sure that everything's not sitting on each other, like it's all like flat on the pot or the pan, I should say. And then once this is all white, then I'll flip it, and then I'll add in the Mrs. Dash. Just a dash of Mrs. Dash. Bam! Alright, so while that's waiting, I'll take a little sip of my water here. Alright, probably flip back to this camera again. So what's up, John? How you been? See, this is nice now, because now I can be cooking, but then I can also, like, not be fucking bored out of my mind while I'm cooking. Because, like, it just takes a long time, and it's always, like, really super frustrating. Delicious. Alright, so, it's starting to white a little bit around the edges. I'm going to give it, like, probably a couple more minutes. Play Minecraft. Oh, play Minecraft. That's so cool. The Minecrafts. Speaking of Minecraft, actually, funny story. One of my students today, my students know that I play games. They actually know that I stream and play. I have a YouTube channel, but I have not told any of them, just for obvious reasons, being a teacher. But they think it's funny that, like, I play video games. Like, I know as much about video games as I do. And one of them today, kind of out of nowhere, was like, I was talking about video games. Like, his kid, he's a senior, which makes this even funnier to me. Out of nowhere, he stands up out of his chair in the middle of a discussion about video games. He goes, you know what? I just want everybody to know, I play Minecraft, and I love it. And he sits down, and everyone's like, okay, why was that such a big deal? And, like, it was just so funny. Because apparently he thought that, like, people were going to give him shit for it. Alright, so, in the middle of it, at least, it looks like it's getting a little bit more white. Just going to give it just another minute. Oil over on this side, though. One other cool thing, one interesting thing about when I cook, I don't really use timers. For stuff like the oven, obviously, yes. But, like, spaghetti, chicken, I just kind of do it by ear, like, by eye, I should say. I just kind of, just watch it myself. Why is this side not cooking very well? Spin it around. Oh, by the way, since you guys get to see me cook chicken, you're going to see some fucking awesome, like, pan flips. I've gotten pretty good at them over the years. Are these cooking on the other side, or what? Oh, they are. All right, I'm going to flip them. Where's my spatula? Where is my spatula? Oh, is it in the goddamn dishwasher? It is. Let me just reach around the camera. Wash this real quick with a sponge. Still has soap in here. Soapy, soapy, soap, soap. Washy, washy, wash, wash. And scrubby, scrubby, scrub, scrub. Perfect! And then we dry it! Aha! Spatula! Alright, so, let's flip these over. Flip, flip, flip a Delphia. Alright, so the bulk of it's flipped. So now, so I'll do is I'll use the spatula to flip, like, the big chunks, and then we'll do it with that big, like, as much as I can. And then I come in and grab the individual ones with the tongs. And also around this time is when I want to just kind of double check to make sure that none of them are sticking together, because obviously that's one of the biggest problems I've been having a lot is like when they get to this stage, they like the ones I told you about, like when I cook the ones and slice them up into eight, they end up sticking together and becoming like one weird like mashed up thing. Okay, so, everything's white on the one side. I'm breaking up all the different little mashups here. So, I don't know if you guys can tell from the camera or not, but, like, the oil in the bottom is starting to bubble. Usually when the oil bubbles, that's when I add my Mrs. Dash. For this, again, I just kind of do it by eye. Like, I don't really have an exact measurement. Do, like, a couple shakes, and then use the tongs to stir it all back in. Because the one good thing that happens is when you have enough vegetable oil at the bottom, all the seasoning gets caught up in the oil. And then when you move it around, obviously the oil, like the chicken moves around a little bit, but not a lot. But then the big thing is that the Chilii, what are you saying? But the seasoning gets caught in the oil, and the oil goes over all the chicken. So it makes it just a little bit better to mix it and make sure everything gets that flavor. Which specifically for this one, it's garlic and herb, right? Yeah, garlic and herb. Garlic and jack herb. Let's split these up. Alright, so good thing here. The chicken should be done within a couple minutes, maybe even like 1 or 2 minutes. Usually some people would, like, leave it on there until it starts to brown. I don't usually do that, just because, especially with the oil, I feel like if you leave it kind of, like, whitish, and well, cooked all the way through, obviously, but if you leave it kind of whitish, I think it tastes a lot better. So I don't always, I don't ever really brown it. The only time it ever really gets browned is when I try to cut it in half and cook the two halves at once, just because the edges get brown, and I'm like, oh, well, they're brown, like, clearly they've been on here for a while, and they're brown, they gotta be done. Then I cut it open, the fucking thing's still raw inside. It's just really frustrating. Alright, so right here, the oil's starting to bubble up again, and the good thing is, once it starts to bubble like this, now it's catching all the extra herb, the garlic, all the seasoning, it's catching the seasoning pretty much, and now when I start moving it around, since it's caught up in that oil, whatever oil it gets on, now it's let's get on to that. Here comes the flips. Oh. Oh. Oh! He's got the skills! They're multiplying. And he's making chicken. Alright. Big one! Ha! There we go. So the good thing is with the flips at least, I don't know if you can tell on this guy right here, but the chicken flips obviously, but also the goal that I'm trying to do is get the oil to kind of come up and flip and get on the top. Because if you leave it on the bottom and just keep stirring it, like even stirring it around, the oil sits at the bottom and only like one half of it, at least to me. I'm fucking talking like I'm a goddamn cooking expert, but I'm really not. Just what I've noticed is that the oil sits at the bottom of the chicken gets all the flavor and all the oil, and the top of it can get really dry. So usually what I'll try to do is just occasionally flip it like this, just so the oil kind of moves and hits the top of the chicken, too. Let me try a piece. All right, there's my chicken. Okay, all right. Bam. Light inside. Nailed it. Well, really, I mean, when the pieces are this small, you really can't mess it up that much. All right, so we've got a little over 2.5 minutes left on the squash. So I'm going to take this off heat. I'm going to grab this, and I originally honestly had planned on, do I have any in the fridge? How much is enough? I originally had planned to, that's not good enough, to make my own Parmesan sauce, because you can, obviously, it's just like it's milk, cheese, all that stuff, and I have most of the ingredients, but not all of them, so I figured, you know, instead of going out and getting a couple things, I'll just use the stuff we already have. So, I don't know if I'm allowed to do product placement. I already did Mrs. Dash. It's just light Parmesan Alfredo ragu. And kind of simple stuff. Just pour a bit in here. There we go. All right. I don't use all of it, but I use a pretty big majority of it. So right now, like for instance, I use enough of it that the jar I have in the fridge now would not have enough to cover the whole thing. So what I'll do instead, turn this down a little bit. Because the thing with sauce is, if you let sauce get too hot, it'll bubble too much and it'll end up like sticking to the sides. So, you know, just me. What was I just saying? Yeah, so the stuff I had left in the fridge, I can switch back to this camera because it's just the sauce. So you're not supposed to think you're not supposed to, so I think you're okay. Sweet. So I just think that words. I keep getting off track. God damn it. I'm the worst chef cooking host ever. So what I was saying is the stuff I have left over, like in a jar this big, like this much of it's left over, which now that I have two jars like that, I can use them to make, like, a lunch or, like, two lunches. But, like, for a dinner, like, it's definitely not enough to make a good enough dinner. All right. Ooh! 30 seconds on the squash! Squash time! Okay. Put that in there. Put that in there. What I need a towel. Be right back. Hold on! Okay. Oh, also, I can turn this off, I just realized, because now the chicken... Damn it. Hey! Timer's off. Turn off the oven. So I'm going to put this down on the counter, just so the hot thing is not directly on the counter. Let me grab my super cool oven mitts, which Katie got for me for Christmas, which I think are really fucking funny, because it's like... I'm a bear! All right, so let's see how these look. Okay, so put that down right there. Okay, all right, let them cool for a bit. So now that we're doing this, this is very lightly cooking, so that's fine. Leave that stuff there, oven mitts off. So what I'm gonna do now, just move the camera one last time. Alright, also get this fucking raw chicken out of here. Put it over here for right now. Put it on my breakfast nook! Okay, so let's just move this real quick. Okay, if I move this to here, is that a good enough view of the squash? Not really. I guess that kind of is. I'll leave that there. Okay, so it's a little hot, nothing terrible. All right, so, that one's hot. There we go. Okay, I think it came out all right. So, the one thing I'm a little concerned right now is, from the video I was watching, it looked like they should be much, not soggier, but not as rigid when they come out. And but whatever. We'll see. So, first thing I'm going to do is grab two forks, and now I'm going to... I'm an idiot. Why did I grab this? All right, so... Seems like it's coming out okay. Actually, hold on. I should probably grab it with this fork. Scrape it. Can I grab it real quick? There we go. Ooh, a little hot. A little hot. All right, but at least it's coming out, and it is actually starting to look like spaghetti, which is kind of cool. It's always a plus. What happens if I do this? Hold on. Camera change! This? Do any of this? What does that have a view of? It has a view of nothing. Nothing. Still nothing. Alright. Back to the coffee. I'll figure this out later on, guys. Damn it. Let's just leave it like this for right now. Okay, so sauce is boiling. Turn it back down just a bit. Okay, also the one thing that I saw before is that they would just serve it directly in the squash. I'm actually not going to do that. What I'm going to do instead is I'm going to grab two plates out of here since this is already open. Okay. Also, I should probably text Katie and ask her when she's going to be home since this is pretty much ready. Let me see. Actually, I'll give her a call. That'll make this easier, so I can use hands-free! Call! There you go. Leave it like that. Put this right here. Later then. Nope, that's her. Hello. What's up? You got home just in time.
I know. I was listening to you in the car ride.
Were you really?
Yeah.
Oh. You're in the way of my camera. I'm kidding.
Anybody watching?
John is.
Hi, John.
All right, so...
How is everybody watching?
Huh? Well, he's been talking to me the whole time.
Oh, I can't see that. Oh, I see that.
Yeah.
Sure. So
one person's
watching?
Yeah. One person's all I need as long as it's a friend. Well, it probably smells like spaghetti squash.
Oh, so you didn't really clean up.
Yes, I did. I cleaned the area that's on. See, John, what did I tell you? I cleaned. And she's like, you didn't really clean. It's not good enough.
You can see the dining room. That is a hot mess.
It is. John, is the dining room a hot mess? You can see. You can't even see it.
I saw it earlier.
Oh, my God. You probably saw, like, one dining room chair, and that was it. All right. Is this enough spaghetti squash for you?
I have no idea.
Do you want to just try a little bit first?
That's all that came out of it?
Of one.
You didn't do this one at all?
No, I didn't do this one at all. Watch. So here's what happens. Ready? So you put the fork in and you scrape it.
Oh, you didn't even start that
one? I didn't even touch that one yet.
Oh, fancy.
All right. Green?
Because as it breaks apart, it's
a mess.
It's not a mess, asshole.
You're all sweaty.
I'm always sweaty! You know that! No, the heat's not on. I've been cooking and I've been living. That's why I'm sweaty.
Saw a bit of it. Oh,
see? It was a table and a bit of a chair. That's it.
You only made one piece of chicken?
I made two.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. I was going to make them, but I figured it'd be easier just to save them for another time. Let me stir this back up a bit.
Tomorrow?
Huh?
Like tomorrow?
Yeah, I guess. All right, grab my spatula. All right.
Can I try?
Chicken down.
Can I try?
Can you try what?
Scraping it.
You want to try and scrape it?
Mm-hmm.
All
right. Did you
try it yet? Try what, spaghetti squash?
Yeah.
No, it literally just came out like 2 minutes ago.
How do you get it out?
Well, I scrape it a bunch and I use the tongs to pull it out.
This doesn't make a lot.
What's only one?
I said it does make a lot.
Oh, it does. I said it doesn't. Okay. Yeah, I like it. What? What do you think?
There you go.
Pretty good?
Is it supposed to be crunchy?
The spaghetti?
Mm-hmm.
I think so. Unless I need to put it in for longer.
Oh, I'm gonna try it.
Where? Let's put some. I was gonna say Parmesan. It's not even fucking Parmesan. It is Parmesan. Wait, it is.
Isn't it Alfredo sauce?
It's. Fuck, what was it? It's the stuff that's in the fridge. There, you take yours. You go sit down. I'm gonna make my plate now. Alright, so let's try to get the rest out of this one.
Don't look at the drawer.
Cover the drawer!
We only had one drawer.
Yeah, so one problem that we always complain about, not really complain about, but we talk about in our apartment, is we only have this one drawer right here, and that's it. We have cabinets and stuff, but like
the utensil drawer and
yeah,
the
so it's
drawer.
The utensil slash junk slash menu slash anything drawer. Alrighty. Does it taste like, what do you mean by, like, just like al dente?
No, like, it tastes like crunchy.
Do you not like it?
Good,
no, it's fine. Did I not do it long enough?
I have no idea how long it's been for.
Half an hour, that's what the recipe said.
Did they tell you, like, different sizes?
No, it said, half an hour at 350 degrees. I already messed it up, John!
I honestly have no idea. What did you say?
I don't know.
Cooking
Google it.
Food.
You want to Google it and see if it's...
Why do you make a sad face?
Huh?
Why do you make... Is that a sad face? I can't always say.
By the way, your little face popping up right there is adorable.
Shut up.
What? You're so cute. I don't know, is spaghetti squash supposed to be crunchy?
Well,
Google.
Yeah, this is like your height. Now I can see myself. Oh,
yeah. Google it. Google it. All right, so let's leave the rest here. If we like it, at least we'll make it into more lunches. Okay. Chicken! Speaking of which, do you want more chicken? We got plenty.
No.
All right, so let's just put that there. Right.
Because he put those in the name, there's no command in the box. Damn you, my.
What?
My bad. Just stupid stuff that I did. More mistakes I made on stream. All right. So mix this.
I can't hear him.
Because he's not. That's not how Twitch works. I don't know how many times I have to tell you this. So look, it's imagine you're watching a movie, but like the movie listens to like text that you can send about it.
That's why.
Yeah, I know. Like, if what I could have done is I could have put John into a Discord and we could have talked that way. No. All right, John. Here is the final product. I'm gonna move the camera. All right, ready? Da 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 da. Final product. Spaghetti squash, chicken Alfredo. I did it. All right. So, I hope you guys enjoyed my first ever Cooking with Chilii stream. I actually might start doing these more often, depending if you guys like it or not. For those that came by to watch, thanks for watching. Until next time, I'll see you guys later.
Bye.